halftime, not anymore. Everything that we did in the second half was there in the first half. Overcome. Fortunately, it was only 7-3 when all those adverse things happened. We were down like 21-0 when those things happened.
When did you decide to start JJ in the second
half? I was going to play JJ in the second half, but I was going to let Kyle go one series and see. And then I said, I'm just going to start him in the second half, and I'll rotate him and give him some throws and see if we can get something going. And I just rotated him. He had a chance to make a couple plays too, but being rusty in there, I think he'll be fine. He just hadn't played, so that just showed.
Do you think Kyle responded to that?
I think Kyle would have played that way in the second half, whether I started JJ or not, because we had pretty good talk at halftime, and he knew what he needed to do.
And obviously, there was a lot there for Zach to take advantage of, and that's really what sparked it. After the Beasley fumble, everything was still kind of falling apart late in the third quarter.
Right, right. Well, you're down 17-3 with 6 minutes to go in the third quarter. You better turn around, and he did, of course.
Was that just a case of Zach taking what was there, or?
I thought the line did a good job, and we changed a couple little things. They were overshifting on some stuff, so we kind of put in a different look of a run that we normally do at halftime, and it worked pretty good.